I'm Rachel from BlueBotics, and in this video, we'll be discussing the navigation technology that drives automated vehicles. If you're embarking on an automation project, it's important to understand the technology. Navigation can be the difference between a successful project and an expensive experiment. In this video, we'll focus on the difference between scan matching and feature matching natural navigation. Natural navigation is an umbrella term for navigation technologies which do not require changes to the physical infrastructure in order for the vehicle to move about. Put simply, today's natural navigation technologies use one of two different methodologies, scan matching and feature matching. We'll break down the difference between these two methods, but first, let's get the terminology clear. Natural navigation technologies are sometimes called free navigation. This can refer to either scan matching, which is sometimes called SLAM navigation, and feature matching technology, such as ANT navigation by BlueBotics. With scan matching technology, measurements from the vehicle's laser scanners are compared, that is matched, to the cells of a grid-based reference map of the environment. The points in the grid-based map can be compared to pixels in a digital image. Of course, this isn't exactly what a scan matching vehicle might see, but it's a helpful way to imagine it. To position, that is localize itself in the map, the navigation system of a scan matching vehicle calculates its position using the match points. At the same time, it uses odometry, which measures the vehicle's change in position by computing its movement. By comparison, with ANT feature matching technology, measurements from the vehicle's laser scanners are compared, that is matched, to permanent map references, such as walls and pillars. Should a part of the site not have enough distinctive features, reflective stickers can also be added to provide additional references. If the reference or grid map of the vehicle using scan matching navigation can be compared to a pixelated photo, then a reference map of a feature matching vehicle is similar to a line drawing. Because the resulting map contains only the coordinates of static, permanent features, it is much smaller in terms of file size than a grid-based map used by scan matching vehicles. A key benefit of matching features rather than laser points is that features are highly distinctive. For example, the size and angle of an entire wall is much more distinctive than a small section of that same wall. That's why features are simpler for the system to identify and successfully match. To localize the vehicle in the map, ANT uses a mix of odometry and feature matching. It excludes all impermanent or dynamic objects, such as pallets, boxes, people, and so on, from its calculations. We're sometimes asked, why exclude dynamic objects? How can a vehicle navigate accurately without seeing everything? Whether an automated vehicle is using feature matching or scan matching, it needs to see and match features in the environment to localize itself accurately. But the proportion of the environmental features they need to match varies dramatically. Vehicles using scan matching need to recognize at least 60% of the environment for accurate positioning, while vehicles using feature matching need to recognize 5% or less of the environment for accurate positioning. In fact, even if no features are matched for several seconds, ANT-driven vehicles can use odometry to navigate for a few meters. Why is there such a big difference? We can answer with the old saying, can't see the forest for the trees. It's very unlikely that an AGV would ever find itself in a forest, but if one did, a scan matching vehicle would scan and map every rustling leaf and passing deer. The resulting map would be very dense, detailed, and all but impossible to match on the next mission, as most things in the forest would be at least slightly different. By comparison, a feature matching vehicle will only focus on the important features. In the same environment, a feature matching vehicle will only map, and in future only match, the tree trunks, the only non-moving parts of the forest, just ignoring everything else. Therefore, ANT-driven vehicles only need to recognize a small percentage of the environment in order to navigate effectively. But wait a minute, if a vehicle ignores dynamic parts of the environment, will that cause collisions? No. For localization purposes, ANT-driven vehicles are programmed to ignore objects in the environment that do not match the static features in this map. This can be thought of like driving a car on a highway. Objects beyond the highway, like houses and trees, can simply be ignored. Even if an object appears in the vehicle's path, it still won't collide. An ant-driven vehicle's laser scanners monitor the environment and detect unexpected or dynamic objects. When these are detected, ant either stops the vehicle or navigates around these objects, depending on how it's programmed. Of course, as a backup, the vehicle's safety system is also capable of performing an emergency stop if necessary. So that's an overview of the major differences between scan matching and feature matching. Now let's take a closer look. First, the products which offer the technology differ. Scan matching is a generic term used by many different brands. Remember, it is often called SLAM navigation. Feature matching is used by Ant by BlueBotics, but the flexible technology means that Ant can be used for any vehicle in any application. As we mentioned before, different parts of the environment have matched. Scan matching scans the entire environment and compares it to a grid-based reference map. Feature matching looks at permanent features in the environment and again compares them to a reference map. Scan matching vehicles need to match at least 60% of the environment for accurate positioning, while feature matching vehicles need to match 5% or less for accurate positioning. Can you tell which navigation technology a vehicle uses just by looking? Maybe. Scan matching technology requires an additional laser scanner on top of a vehicle, while feature matching technology typically uses the vehicle's built-in safety laser scanner. Using an additional scanner adds another component cost for the vehicle maker, and likely a higher end price for the vehicle buyer. Each additional piece of hardware adds one more potential point of failure. Placing laser scanners on top of the vehicle also restricts the type of vehicles a producer can offer to the market. For example, using a separate scanner for navigation does not enable a vehicle maker to produce a low underride or mouse type AGV that are designed to move underneath a cart. Lasers placed high on the vehicle are more sensitive to tilting or yawing caused by uneven surfaces or soft tires, and this can affect accuracy. Natural navigation is sometimes called SLAM navigation. However, SLAM, that is simultaneous localization and mapping, is only a small part of the process. Both use scan matching and feature matching technologies. Both scan matching and feature matching technology use SLAM when creating the initial reference map. Scan matching vehicles then continue to use SLAM intermittently when updating the reference map, while feature matching vehicles do not use SLAM after the initial map creation. What about Wi-Fi? Automated guided vehicles are typically linked to a warehouse management system, and this sometimes means they need to be online or use Bluetooth or other wireless communication. But with feature matching navigation, the map a vehicle uses never needs to be updated unless permanent features in the environment change. For example, if a wall is moved or if machinery which was previously bolted to the floor is moved. Instructions are sent from the WMS to the ant-driven vehicle's embedded mission control piecemeal. Therefore, ant-driven vehicles do not need strong and consistent Wi-Fi access to run. BlueBotics customers report that spotty on-site Wi-Fi is often sufficient, and connectivity is only required for server-led interactions, such as when the vehicle interfaces with equipment, like elevators and automatic doors, and for traffic control. In comparison, if a vehicle uses scan matching technology and regularly updates the map, this requires strong, consistent wireless connectivity, which is not always the case in warehouses and on shop floors. This is because each updated map must be downloaded by each vehicle in the fleet from a central server, ideally in close to real time. Remember, these incredibly detailed grid-based maps can have very large file sizes. Both scan matching and feature matching technologies are very accurate. However, Ant is accurate repeatedly over time and does not lose accuracy like a scan matching vehicle may sometimes do. With Ant, you can achieve accuracy of approximately plus or minus 1 centimeter and plus or minus 1 degree. We've covered the major differences between scan matching and feature matching navigation technology, but which is best for your business? Each business has its own unique challenges, but for ease of use, accuracy, and robustness in operation, we believe that feature matching navigation with Ant is the clear choice for any vehicle type and application. Watch our recent webinar on BlueBotics.com to take a deeper dive into more navigation technologies, including line following and tag following. Or reach out to us with any questions about how Ant can help your business grow. At BlueBotics, we have a team of automation specialists dedicated to helping companies create automated guided vehicles which navigate accurately every time. You can get in touch with us via BlueBotics.com. And be sure to click the subscribe button to get notified the next time we post a video like this.